In this video, we are going to discuss about construction working of orifice meter, which is a type of flow meter used to measure the flow rate of liquid or gas or vapor flowing through a pipe. And also we will see the derivation of discharge equation of orifice meter. This device works on principle of differential pressure measurement. It means when a fluid whose flow rate is to be determined is passed through an orifice meter, then there is drop in pressure between the inlet section and outlet section. This drop in pressure can be measured using a differential pressure measuring instrument, because as per Bernoulli's equation, the differential pressure which is developed across the orifice plate is directly proportional to flow rate of fluid flowing through a pipe. The orifice plate is installed between inlet and outlet segments and used to generate pressure drop which enable the measurement of flow rate. It is a flat circular plate with a precisely machined hole in the center called as orifice. The orifice plate creates restriction in the flow, causing a pressure drop. It is typically made of stainless steel material. The orifice meter includes two straight pipe sections. The upstream pipe section is the section of pipe just before the orifice plate, and the downstream pipe section is the section of pipe just after the orifice plate. Flanges are used to connect orifice meter to the pipeline. They are usually made of metal and provide secure and leak tight connection. Flanges allow for easy installation, removal and maintenance of orifice meter. During the working of orifice meter, the fluid flows inside the inlet section having pressure P1. As liquid flows through a pipe of area A1, the flow suddenly contracts as it approaches the orifice and then suddenly expands after orifice back to full pipe diameter. This forms a jet of fluid at section 2, whose area is less than the area of orifice. So this small cross-sectional area of a fluid at section 2 is called as vena contracta. For this contraction of a fluid flow, I will use expression that is A2 equal to CC into AO, where CC is the coefficient of contraction and AO is the area of orifice, and A2 is the area of vena contracta at section 2. This reduction of area in flow pattern at vena contracta causes increased velocity and hence lowers the pressure at the throat. This lower pressure is denoted as P2, which is a pressure of fluid at section 2. The difference in pressure between the upstream and downstream sides of orifice plate is determined by subtracting the downstream pressure from the upstream pressure. And the amount of pressure difference, that is P1 minus P2, which we can find out with the help of differential pressure gauge, which has connected between the inlet and throat section of orifice meter. This difference in pressure is in direct proportion to flow rate of fluid flowing through a pipe. Here small x is the manometric reading in millimeter of mercury, which we can measure on differential manometer. And by using another formula, we can convert small x value into small h. So this small h is the pressure head in meter of water is used to calculate flow rate of fluid in the pipe. Now we will see how to derive this equation. So let us consider a horizontal pipe in that an orifice meter is fitted and the water is flowing, as you can see in the diagram. Let P1 be the pressure at section 1 and P2 be the pressure at section 2. V1 is the velocity at section 1 and V2 is the velocity at section 2. D1 is the diameter of pipe at section 1. A1 is the area of pipe at section 1. D2 is the diameter of vena contracta at section 2. And A2 is the area of vena contracta at section 2. DO is the diameter of orifice and AO is the area of orifice. Normally, the diameter of orifice, that is DO, is half of the diameter of pipe, that is D1. Here H1 and H2 are the heights from the ground. Now applying Bernoulli's equation in both the sections 1 and 2, assuming no loss of energy. Here rho is the density of fluid flowing through a pipe and small g is acceleration due to gravity. Here, I will divide rho g on the both the sides of equation in order to cancel the same terms from the numerator. Now h1 and h2 will be cancelled because both having same heights from the ground. Now I will rearrange the equation in order to get the term p1 minus p2 upon rho g at the left hand side, which is pressure head, where the unit of small h is in meter of fluid flowing inside the pipe, and small h can be calculated with the help of small x value, where small x is the reading of differential pressure gauge in millimeter of mercury. Now I am applying the continuity equation, which is the product of cross-sectional area and velocity. Now I will put the value of V1 in above equation of small h. After simplifying the whole equation, we will get V2. Now the discharge through an orifice meter, that is capital Q, equal to A2V2. Where for V2, I have already obtained the equation. So I will substitute this. So this is the discharge through orifice meter under ideal condition, which is called as theoretical discharge. And actual discharge is the product of theoretical discharge and coefficient of discharge. After simplifying the whole equation, we will get actual discharge. So here we have finally made the derivation of orifice meter. During solving the numericals on orifice meter, the value of small x will be given in problem, or we can measure this on differential pressure gauge, and by using this formula we can convert small x into small h, because in discharge formula, with the help of small h, we can calculate discharge of fluid. It means that small x and small h both are the pressure heads, but the unit of small x is in millimeter of manometric fluid that we can read on manometer, and the unit of small h is in meter of a fluid flowing inside the pipe. So I will first read small x value on differential manometer and convert small x value into small h value by using this formula. And by using calculated value of small h, further we can calculate discharge of fluid flowing inside the pipe. Now we will see comparison between orifice meter and venturi meter. In orifice meter, there is no convergent and divergent cones, so that losses are more and coefficient of discharge is less. Whereas in venturi meter, the losses are less due to presence of convergent and divergent cones. Therefore, discharge is high. Orifice meter requires less space for installation as compared to venturi meter. Orifice meter is simple in construction and it is cheaper than venturi meter. Now we will see the four hydraulic coefficients. In that, first is coefficient of contraction, is the ratio of area of jet at vena contracta to the area of orifice. Coefficient of velocity is the ratio of actual velocity of jet at vena contracta to the theoretical velocity of jet. Coefficient of discharge is the ratio of actual discharge through an orifice to theoretical discharge. Coefficient of resistance is the ratio of loss of head in orifice to the head of water available at the exit of orifice.